गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज सी जॉन पॉल, लेक्चरर इन इंग्लिश ऑफ श्री वेंकटेश्वर कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड साइंस अमलापुरम, एफिलेटेड आदिकवि यूनिवर्सिटी राजमहेंद्रवरम। वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द सेकंड ईयर फोर्थ सेमिस्टर कम्युनिकेशन एंड सॉफ्ट स्किल्स पेपर। The first unit, soft skills. Five lessons are there. These five lessons are completed. The next one is today. We are discussing second unit. The second unit name is paragraph writing. Paragraph writing. What is a paragraph and structure, features, format, all these things learned in this unit. How to write a paragraph, these all things. First of all, few minutes discuss about the title. Your ability to compose a good paragraph will go a long way, will go a long way in determining your success in written communication. A paragraph is a series of sentences related to a topic or theme, arranged or organized carefully to describe, narrate or present your perspective of a topic. Almost every piece of writing you do that is longer than a few sentences should be organized into paragraphs. Regardless of the kind of information it contains. What is a paragraph? What is a paragraph? A paragraph is a group of connected sentences dealing with a single or a specified subject. Single or a specified subject. This is called paragraph. A paragraph is a group of related sentences developed on a specific topic. It may be a part or a division of an essay, or it may be a complete unit in itself. Sometimes it is considered as a mini essay. Sometimes it is considered as a mini essay. However, the basic difference between a paragraph and an essay is that an essay discusses many aspects of a topic, whereas a paragraph focuses on a single aspect. The paragraphs in an essay have a purpose. The beginning of a new paragraph in an essay indicates that the writer has changed the point. This is the complete information regards to a paragraph. We have been told in our school that we shall divide our essay into paragraphs, and each paragraph should be connected to each other. Then we wondered why we need paragraphs. What is actually a paragraph? What is the structure of a good paragraph? We shall learn answers to these questions in this lesson and learn how to write a good paragraph also. Already said the definition of paragraph. What is a paragraph? Simply remember, a paragraph is a group of connected sentences dealing with a single or a specific subject. That is a paragraph. The next one is the need for a paragraph. The need for a paragraph. A paragraph is the smallest unit of writing. A paragraph is the smallest unit of writing. It is written by developing a single idea, even on feeling, and therefore it is the smallest unit of writing. For example, read the following passage. Do you think it needs to be divided into paragraphs? ఒక పారాగ్రాఫ్ ఇక్కడ ఉంది, దీన్ని నేను రీడ్ చేస్తాను. తర్వాత దీన్ని పారాగ్రాఫ్ కింద మనం డివైడ్ చేయాలి. కంటిన్యూస్గా ఇచ్చేసారు. దే కేమ్ డౌన్ స్టేర్స్ ఎవయింగ్ నెక్స్ట్ మార్నింగ్, బట్ స్కిమ్మింగ్ అండ్ మిల్కింగ్ వర్ ప్రొసీడెడ్ విత్ యాజ్ యూజువల్ అండ్ దే వెంట్ ఇండోర్స్ టు బ్రేక్ఫాస్ట్. డైరీ మ్యాన్ క్రిక్ వాజ్ డిస్కవర్డ్ స్టాంపింగ్ అబౌట్ ది హౌస్. హీ హ్యాడ్ రిసీవ్డ్ ఎ లెటర్ ఇన్ విచ్ ఎ కస్టమర్ హ్యాడ్ ఎ కంప్లైంట్ దట్ ద బటర్ హ్యాడ్ ఎ పంగ్ and banged so hard that the dairyman, who held in his left hand a wooden cylinder on which a lump of butter was stuck. Yes, tasty for yourself, several of them gathered round him, and Mr. Carl tested also the other indoor milkmaids, one or two of the milking men, and last of all Mr. Crick, who came out from the writing breakfast table. There certainly was a thang. The dairyman, who had thrown himself into abstraction to better realize the taste and so divine the particular species of naxosis wood to which it appeared, suddenly exclaimed, "Tit traggles, and I thought there was not able a bland left in that maid." This is a essay passage. Yes, the passage above needs to be divided into paragraphs since three are several ideas. Though it is not very long, this passage is about an angry dairyman. It is interesting because there is some kind of suspense. However, it is uninteresting in terms of structure, as there are no paragraphs. If we carefully look at it, The passage has four pieces of information. నాలుగు భాగాలుగా దీన్ని విభజించవచ్చు. ఒకటి, ద డిస్క్రిప్షన్ ఆఫ్ ది డైరీ మ్యాన్స్ యాంగర్. రెండు, ద డైరీ మ్యాన్స్ క్వశ్చనింగ్. మూడు, ద పీపుల్ అరౌండ్ టెస్టింగ్ ద ట్రూత్. ఫోర్త్ వన్, ద డైరీ మ్యాన్స్ కంక్లూజన్. దీస్ పీసెస్ ఆఫ్ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆర్ నాట్ క్లియర్లీ సెపరేటెడ్. దేర్ఫోర్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు మేక్ ఎన్ ఐడియా డిస్టింక్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ అనదర్ వీ నీడ్ పారాఫ్రేజింగ్. పారాఫ్రేజింగ్ హెల్ప్స్ అస్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద ప్యాసేజ్ ఈజీలీ. సో నౌ లుక్ ఎట్ హౌ థామస్ హార్డ్లీ హ్యాస్ పుట్ ద అబోవ్ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ ఇన్ టు ఫోర్ పారాగ్రాఫ్స్ ఇన్ హిస్ నవల్. ఫస్ట్ పారాగ్రాఫ్, దే కేమ్ డౌన్ స్టైర్స్ హెవయింగ్ నెక్స్ట్ మార్నింగ్ బట్ స్కిమ్మింగ్ అండ్ మిల్కింగ్ వార్ ప్రొసీడెడ్ విత్ యాజ్ యూజువల్ అండ్ దే వెంట్ ఇండోర్స్ టు బ్రేక్ఫాస్ట్ డైరీ మ్యాన్ క్లిక్ వాజ్ డిస్కవర్డ్ స్టాంపింగ్ అబౌట్ ద హౌస్ ఈ హ్యాడ్ రిసీవ్డ్ ఏ లెటర్ ఇన్ విచ్ కస్టమర్ హ్యాడ్ కంప్లైంట్ దట్ ద బటర్ హ్యాడ్ ఏ స్ట్రాంగ్. దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఫస్ట్ పారాగ్రాఫ్. ద నెక్స్ట్ పారాగ్రాఫ్, అండ్ బ్యాగ్డ్ సో హ్యాడ్ హ్యావ్ దట్ ద డైరీ మ్యాన్ హూ హెల్డ్ ఇన్ ఈజ్ లెఫ్ట్ హ్యాండ్ ఏ వుడెన్ స్లింగ్ ఆన్ విచ్ ఏ లంబ్ ఆఫ్ బటర్ వాజ్ స్ట్రక్ ఎస్ టేస్టీ ఫర్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్. This is second paragraph. Third paragraph, several of them gathered around him and Mr. Clam tested also the another indoor milkmaids, one or two of the milking men, and last of all Mrs. Click, who came out from the writing breakfast table. There are certainly was a strong. This is third paragraph. And the last paragraph, the diary man who had thrown himself into abstraction to better realize their taste and so divine the particular species of Naxosus who to which it appear train suddenly exclaimed, "Think squarely," and I thought there was not a bland left in that maid. To summarize a paragraph are necessary to distinguish one bit of information from another, which makes the passage comprehensible. This is the paragraph dividing and maintain the paragraphs. So the next one is how to write our effective good paragraph. How to write our effective good paragraph. So coming to the first important question, what is paragraph and how to write an effective paragraph or a good paragraph? So a paragraph is a group of related sentences dependent on a specific topic. It may be a part or a division of an essay, or it may be a complete unit itself. Sometimes it is considered as a mini essay. A paragraph is a group of connected sentences dealing with a singular specific subject. This is paragraph. And how to write an effective paragraph? You have tried to learn 9 points. First one, think about the topic on which you have to compose a paragraph. Think about the topic on which have you to compose a paragraph. Next, good paragraphs are always based on carefully gathered facts on topic. Good paragraphs are always based on carefully gathered facts on topic. Third one, put down 5 to 10 ideas on the topic that comes to your mind. Third one, keeping the topic, audience and purpose of the paragraph in mind. Please check if there are any irrelevant points. Drop them if you find such points. And the fifth one, arrange the topic or arrange the points, arrange the topic points in a chronological or sequential or logical order, placing the topic sentence at the beginning or at the end of the paragraph. Use connectivities, pronouns and other references, word and change some of the sentences. If you think it would be make your paragraph more coherent and effective, expand your points into complete sentences and do not make your paragraph too long. Use variety in sentences, length and structure to make the paragraph more interesting. So read the paragraph again, revise and make corrections if needed. These 9 points, if you maintain, definitely will write a effective paragraph. Effective paragraph. So useful transmission source to write an effective paragraph, like to show edition again, and also besides, moreover, next. This is the extension of words. And sometimes to give examples. For example, for instance, it fact, in fact, to illustrate like this. To compare, like also, likewise, similarly. To contrast, although, yet, at the same time, but nevertheless, these are 2 contrast words. And to conclude words, in conclusion, in short, to sum up like this. Next, to show time, after, as long as, so after, before, during, earlier, finally. The next one, to show place or directions, above, below, beyond, close, elsewhere, opposite. These are show place words or directions. To indicate a relationship words, accordingly, because, as a result, consequently, otherwise, silence, so, therefore. These are useful transmission words to write an effective paragraph. The next one is important. Question is, what is a paragraph and what are the features of good paragraph? What is a paragraph? And what are the features of good paragraph? Features of good paragraph. Features of good paragraph. So, this is very important. A paragraph is a group of connected sentences dealing with a singular specified subject. Next, features of a good paragraph. Introduction. A paragraph is not just a collection of sentences together. Each sentence is in a paragraph is connected to other sentences. All the sentences in a paragraph are related to each other both structurally and semantically. They hang together to make a sensible paragraph. The structural relationship between the sentences is defined by cohesion and semantic relationship by coherence. A good paragraph is a combination of unity, cohesion, coherence, balance, variety, and emphasis. These six are features of a good paragraph. Let us discussing about these six features. First one, unity. Words make up a sentence and sentences make up a paragraph. A paragraph deals with one main thought at a time or one main topic or theme. When the sentences of a paragraph are held together because of their close relation to the central theme, their oneness of purpose gives unity to the paragraph. If sentences don't relate to the central idea, creep into the paragraph, that its unity is destroyed. The result is confused. So they have a unity of theme. For example, the following paragraph fails to satisfy these two conditions. I have finished reading Sons and Lovers by D.H. Lawrence, but my friends have not stopped playing football yet. Therefore, we wish to go on a picnic, and it is a good idea to rest a while after the journey. However, I am taking my final examination this year. So this is a paragraph. द अबव पैराग्राफ कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए ग्रुप ऑफ ग्रामेटिकली करेक्ट सेंटेंसेस हाउएवर इट डज नॉट मेक एनी सेंस इट डज नॉट मेक एनी सेंस बिकॉज इट इज ओनली कलेक्शन ऑफ सेंटेंसेस अरेंज्ड वन आफ्टर द अदर इन लाइनर एंड ऑर्डर बट आर नॉट रिलेटेड टू वन अनदर इन मीनिंग इन दिस पैराग्राफ कंप्लीटली मिस द यूनिटी द फर्स्ट फीचर इज यूनिटी द पैराग्राफ डील्स विथ वन मेन थॉट एट ए टाइम दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सो रिमेंबर व्हेन यू हैव प्रिपेयर्ड और मेक अप ए पैराग्राफ ट्राई टू लिंक एंड मेंटेन सेंटेंस टू अनदर वन एंड यूनिटी दे हैव यूनिटी ऑफ थीम द नेक्स्ट वन इज कोहीशन द नेक्स्ट वन इज कोहीशन कोहीशन मीन्स द सेंटेंस इन ए पैराग्राफ आर लिंक्ड स्ट्रक्चरली लिंक्ड स्ट्रक्चरली बाय कोहीशन डिवाइसेस These devices make the paragraph economic, stable, and clear. Economic, stable, and clear. Some of these such devices are conjunctions, pronouns, and the definite articles the. So, for example, conjunctions are those words that connect two or more words phrases or sentences some conjunctions add the meaning of addition some connect two or more alternatives and some have meanings like comparison condition and consensus for example consider the following sentence I say a few sentences one Krishna studies at the university and he works at the canteen. This is addition. You can either study in the university or work in a bank. This is alternatives. Though he worked hard, he failed in the examination. Consensus. So, in all the three sentences above the conjunctions and either or and though connect the clauses clear two conjunctions are there subordinative conjunctions or general conjunctions are there and pronouns are definite articles also used in many times to connected the sentence to sentence phrases to phrases clauses to clauses So, for example, subordinative conjunctions are the words that are used to introduce dependent clauses in complete sentence. A subordinative conjunction occurs at the beginning of a dependent clause. Some of the subordinative conjunctions in English are that, because, as, since, and when. Example. The vice principal announced that the final exams will be held in April every year. When we went to college, we found the college gates closed. So here are the one phrase depending on the another one. So the next one is, third one is coherence. First one is unity. Second one is cohesion. Third one is coherence. Coherence. We saw that cohesion is a surface phenomenon. Surface phenomenon. That is, we can see cohesive devices. And they connect one sentence with another in a paragraph. But Remember, using only cohesive devices do not make a good paragraph. The sentences should also be connected through semiotics. That is, they should also be related in terms of meaning. As pointed out earlier, all the sentences in a paragraph should deal with a single idea. This semiotic relationship between sentences is called coherence. They are semiotically united. For example, consider the following paragraph. I read one paragraph now. Standard procedures for treatment of heart-related diseases are expensive. A private hospital, despite having good intentions, will expect the patient to pay a cent or a coated metal pipe placed at the spot of occlusion costs around 80,000 rupees. A week's stay in the intensive care unit of good hospital cost around 50,000. If we add the cost of investigation and the cost of injections, saline bottles, medicines and other medical necessities, the total will be close of 2,10,000. So this paragraph deals with a single idea, the cost of treatment of heart diseases. The first sentence introduced the idea. Other sentence in paragraph supported to the idea. To summarize, a good paragraph is combination of coherent and cohesive sentences. Cohesive or cohesive refers to prepare connections between one sentence and another sentence to affiliate it. The reader move from one thought to another. On the other hand, coherence in a paragraph refers to the unity in meaning. Each sentence should be focused on the idea expressed in the paragraph. This is coherence. The next one is balance. The balance, fourth feature of good paragraph writing. The balance of the paragraph depends on the proper distribution of emphasis. It is closely connected with the logical development of the thought. The space devoted to each sentence should be in proportion to the importance of the idea it expresses. Care should also be taken to see that the main idea stands out prominently. It should not be obscured or weakened as the paragraph progresses. An excellent device that helps to emphasize the main theme is to close the paragraph on a prime note suggestive of the central idea, or it may be closed with summarizing sentence recapitulation the main points deals with. So sometimes the central idea is not expressed at the outset but is delaying to the middle of the paragraph or even to the end. In such cases, the sentences that come before or intended to be preparatory. Then the objective of the writer is to keep the reader in suspense until the main idea springs upon him in the nature of a surprise, thereby highlighting the effect. This is the balance. And the next one is variety. Variety means collection of different things, simply. Another principle in paragraph construction is variety. It is meant to avoid monotony. It should be of different lengths and not always of the same sentence construction. A judge blends of the simple, complex and compound sentences will be impressive. Therefore, a paragraph should contain only one basic idea. All the sentences in a paragraph should be closely interrelated. They should serve to illustrate and explain the basic idea. The chief function of a paragraph is to give both the writer and the reader rest for a moment to reflect and survey what has been written so far. A paragraph, therefore, should not be very long. An arresting opening sentence and full and rounded final sentence in conclusion are essential to a good paragraph. This is variety. The last one is emphasis. Emphasis. Generally, the opening sentences contains the subject or theme of paragraph. The following sentence expand or illustrate the main subject. A paragraph should come to a natural close when the treatment of the particular subject is exhausted. The idea which has been developed in a paragraph must determine the arrangement and the relative importance of the subordinate parts. So a forceful quality in the way something is said or written, that is called emphasis. And so you have maintained sometimes style also. The style depending on two important considerations. One is audience and another purpose. Consider the following paragraph. Example, one noticing the unfamiliar person clothed in gargoyles, real rebels, the learned man of the rustic academy rose up as if prompted by reverence and fight. At his demeanor betrayed a sense of amazement rather than timeroness. Seeing the stranger in a beautiful, kindly dress, the village schoolmaster stood up as if forced by respect and fear. But his behavior showed as a feeling of wonder rather than timidly. So both the above paragraphs have the same meaning, but express it in different styles. This stylistic choice is made by the writer depending on his purpose and his esteem about the reader. The writer of the first text employs an elevated literary style and expects his reader to be familiar with high flow vocabulary. The writer of the second text uses plain, straightforward style and is addressing an ordinary reader who knows simple English. So this is the maintain the style. So the most important question discussed in this video: what is paragraph, what is the need of paragraph, what is the effect, how to write the effective paragraph, and what are the features of paragraph. Thank you.